Introduction. We celebrate today the living Christ, our advocate with the Father, in whose name repentance for the forgiveness of sins is preached to all the world, which is exactly what Peter is seen doing at the entrance of the temple. Let us also realize our mission as Christians to cooperate with the risen Lord and win people for Him. Please stand and join in the entrance hymn as we welcome the celebrant.
Feed the hungry at your door, share your clothing with the poor. Then at last your light will shine, your wounds will heal. Break the yoke of the oppressed, take the homeless as your guest. In the darkness of their night, you be the here I am, Lord, I am listening, I have heard you call me by my name. Keep me open to your word, Lord, may you pour on me your Spirit's flame.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of God our Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear people, in today's gospel, Jesus invites the world to repent and believe the good news of salvation. Jesus is the good news that people need to hear. He came into this world as a merciful and a loving Savior, and He's ever ready to forgive, but provided we repent and wholeheartedly come to Him to receive His grace, His blessings, His peace, which He offers those who love Him, who want to follow Him. Let us humbly call to mind our sins, ask God to pardon us as we prepare to celebrate this Holy Eucharist. This Mass is offered for the following intentions: for the souls of Francis Pereira and ancestors, Selu, Flora and Tony George, Dorothy Placida Menezes, Stephen Fernandez, Ketira, John Pinto, Francis Amaro, Veronica Da Costa, Agnes, Anthony Rego, Mary D'Souza, Andrew Cyril, and Alfonso, Pascal Sebastian, Celestine Alfonso, Anthony Xavier, Delphine D'Souza, Maureen Pereira, Mans Mainmas, Sebastian Barreto, offered by Ferry Barreto, John and Effie Denise, souls in purgatory, souls of the departed members of the Da Costa, Da Silva, Rodericks, and Chu family, Ravindra Kali, Fermino Vaz, Ida, Xavier, Anne Milagres Fernandez, Asmo Severine Da Silva, for the departed souls of the family, Xavier Rodericks, for the soul of the Dissa and Fernandez departed souls, Jason Moniz, Angela Ribello, first death anniversary, Floriano Nano Carvalho, Visitation Fernandez, Inacin Fernandez, Renato Pereira and the departed family members, Francis Afonso, R.B. Da Costa and the departed family members, Ben and Linda George Larry and Bertha Sequeira, departed souls of the Pereira family, Rodrigues family, Joseph Cosmo Rodrigues, Augustine and Maria Menezes, Marcelino John Pereira, Custodio M. Fernandez, Angras Barbosa, Diana D'Souza, Francis Ticuna, Assisi Jacks and ancestors, Santan Rodrigues, Father German Lemos, Justina Albuquer, Joseph D'Souza, Anthony Dias, Joseph Cosmo and Yungia Rodrigues, first death anniversary, Thomas De Silva, Michael and Enriqueta Carvalho, Concesao and Rosie Rodrigues, and Ben Pereira. This mass is also offered for the spiritual and temporal welfare of all benefactors and donors of the society. It's a thanksgiving offered by Agnel and Cathy, Constancio and Elrina Rodrigues, Father Byron Mendonca, Joachim and Fenny, Cajetan, Pauline and the family, Francis Benna and family, Ian D'Souza. Thanksgiving in honor of divine mercy offered by Joachim and Kalpana in the wedding anniversary. Healing and blessings of marriage, partners for Asmita, Sean and Dudes. For the good health of Agnella and Anselm, Claricia Cotino de Rosario, Prudy Manchardia, for the blessings on all who are seeking employment, for good health of Shane Cotino. Together we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I've greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words and what I've done and what I've failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord have mercy, Christ have mercy, Lord have mercy on us.
With joy and gratitude in our hearts, let us sing the Gloria.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. May your people exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward to, in confident hope, to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, glorified his servant Jesus, whom you delivered over and denied in the presence of Pilate, when he had decided to release him. But you denied the Holy and Righteous One, and asked for a murderer to be granted to you. And you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witnesses. And now, brothers, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did also your rulers. But what God foretold by the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer, he thus fulfilled. Repent, therefore, and turn back, that your sins may be blotted out." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We shall sing the response. Lift up the light of your face on us, O Lord. Can you repeat? Lift up the light of your face on us, O Lord.
I called, the God of justice gave me answer. From anguish you released me. Have mercy and hear me.
Lift up the light of your face on us, O Lord.
Know that the Lord works wonders for his faithful ones. The Lord will hear me whenever I call him.
Lift up the light of your face on us, O Lord.
What can bring us happiness, many say. Lift up the light of your face on us, O Lord.
Lift up the light of your face on us, O Lord.
In peace I will lie down and fall asleep. For you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety.
Lift up the light of your face on us, O Lord.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Christ Jesus the righteous. He is the propitiation of our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. And by this we know that we have come to know him, if we keep his commandments. Whoever says, "I know him," but does not keep his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. But whoever keeps his word, in him truly the love of God is perfected. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand as we prepare our hearts for the gospel.
Amen. Alleluia. Amen. Alleluia. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia. Amen.
Lord Jesus, open the scriptures to us. Make our hearts burn with love when you speak to us.
Amen. Alleluia. Amen. Alleluia.
Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, the two disciples told what had happened on the road and how Jesus was known to them in the breaking of the bread. As they were talking about these things, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace to you." But they were startled and frightened and thought they saw a spirit. And he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? See my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see. For a spirit does not have flesh and bones, as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. And while they still disbelieved for joy and were marveling, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate before them. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures and said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ should suffer and on the third day rise from the dead, and the repentance for the forgiveness of sins should be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things."
Praise, praise, praise be to Jesus, now and evermore.
Together.
Praise, praise, praise be to Jesus, now and evermore.
My dear brothers and sisters, today's readings remind us that we are called to be disciples of the Lord, to become more and more like Jesus, to share his message, to continue this work of spreading the gospel to the ends of the earth. And the Lord does not just leave us by ourselves. He helps us, he accompanies us, he is with us. As in today's gospel passage, you see the disciples experiencing the presence of the Lord. When he ate with them and spoke to them, they felt his presence, they encountered the Lord, they spoke to him and he spoke to them and ate with them. And that brought tremendous joy and happiness and the strength to go out and share this good news that Jesus is alive, that they met him in his glorified body and he will never die again. He has conquered sin and death. And he wants us to also share his glory and be with him for all eternity. And so we see in today's first reading how Saint Peter and the apostles go about preaching, and they accept his message. He preaches a message of repentance and invites people to realize that yes, we have our human weaknesses, and it's possible because of our human frailty to fall into sin, to go against God's law, and to do things that are against the will of God. But God is willing to reach out and lift us up, provided we repent, just as the prodigal son returns back to the father with a humble, contrite heart. That is what every child of God needs to do. We are all created by God and we are all his beloved children. And he wants all of us to have that life in abundance, not to get rid of that bitterness and hurt feelings that are in us, and to be more loving and caring like Jesus. It is said that each one of us are like a pencil in the loving hand of God. You know, just as a pencil sometimes would write something, and what is written with pencil can be erased. And also a pencil at times needs to be sharpened so it can write, be written, can be used well, and the writing is beautiful and people are able to read and understand and appreciate what is written. And so each one of us are like a pencil in the loving hand of God. And it is God who does the thinking and the creativity and the writing. We are only instruments in His hand which He uses. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, we need to just humble ourselves and surrender our lives to the Lord. And He will use us to reach out to others and to fulfill that mission that each and every baptized Christian is given, to be messengers of the gospel, to be His instruments, His ambassadors in the world, to share the message of salvation to all humanity. And that is a privilege to each one of us, a responsibility that is given to us. And we, as we live in these troubled times, there are so many people who are sad or suffering, and they are waiting for a word of comfort, encouragement, for a phone call, just to find out how they are. And it brings so much of joy to know that people care and are concerned about their well-being and happiness. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, God is giving us opportunities to be His instruments in the world today, to share the love and the good things that Jesus did, His gospel message, and the miracles that He did. We see that seeing the miracles that were done through the apostles, many people believed the message of salvation, and thousands of people were joined to the church. Even in Jerusalem, they say 5,000 people were converted and became Christians. That's a big number for people to come to the Lord. And today too, the harvest is plenty, but the laborers are few. Each one of us is called to be a laborer in the Lord's harvest, the Lord's vineyard, and to help in this work of sharing the good news with others. My dear brothers and sisters, Mother Teresa once said, all of us may not do great things, but the little things that we can do with great love. And that will inspire people to believe in Jesus. That will be the message that we can give others. And each one of us can be a missionary as we, through our very lives, reach out to others, forgive others, help others, comfort those who are suffering, and be active as members in the family, in the church, in the community, at the workplace. Each one of us can make a difference, bring a smile on the face of others, bring joy, happiness, as we share what we have with others, as we reach out in forgiveness and encourage others to forgive, encourage, motivate others to share, as they see our generosity and kindness, our love, our prayerfulness. We can also pray for people that they may listen to the gospel and hear the word of God and be filled with peace, joy and happiness, which only God can give. And He gives very freely to those who come humbly with a contrite heart to receive these things. Today let us ask Jesus, who is present with us. He is present at every Eucharist, and the sacraments He is present. Through the sacrament of confession we experience His presence. Through the Eucharist we receive His precious body and blood, which invites us to make sacrifices for others, to love others, to care for those around us, to be His witnesses in the world. It is He who inspires us, enlightens our minds, our hearts. As we surrender our lives to Him, He will help us, He will strengthen us, He will accompany us, He will be our companion on the way in our journey through life, to be His messengers of peace around us. Amen. Let us profess our Christian faith as we say the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, was born of the Virgin Mary, He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body and life everlasting. Amen. Prayer of the faithful. The risen Lord empowers his disciples to continue his work of proclaiming repentance in his name. Let us place our petitions before God. Our responses: Lord, graciously hear us. Together:
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for Pope Francis, bishops, clergy and the religious, that they may gently work and accompany those on the periphery of society to lead them to conversion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all Christians, that by our genuine Christian living and example, we may strive to influence people around us through our small Christian community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those who are suffering from COVID-19 in this spread of the pandemic, that they may experience a healing presence of the risen Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all of us in the Eucharistic assembly, that we may adhere always to the death resurrection mystery of Christ and experience forgiveness of sins through the sacrament of reconciliation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Kindly pray for your personal and local needs. Our response:
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those who celebrate their birthdays, weddings and anniversaries today and during this month of April, that the Lord may shower his blessings upon them. God, our Father, your Son Jesus, risen from the dead, reveals to us the mysteries of the resurrection. Grant that sharing in his paschal mystery, we may become genuine witnesses of his kingdom. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Take our bread, we ask you, take our hearts. We love you, take our lives. Oh Father, we are yours. We are yours. Yours as we stand at the table, you said. Yours as we eat the bread our hearts can't forget. We are the signs of your life with us yet. We are yours.
We are yours.
We are yours.
We are yours.
Take our bread, we ask you, take our hearts. We love you, take our lives. Oh Father, we are yours. We are yours.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, dear brethren, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, our Heavenly Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Come and sing Hosanna in the highest. Come and sing Hosanna in the highest. He who comes is blessed in the Lord's name. He who comes is blessed in the Lord's name. Come and sing Hosanna in the highest. Come and sing Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the Most Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyr, Saint Francis Xavier, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us wish one another the peace, joy, and love of Jesus.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Jesus is our Prince of Peace. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
We now make our spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace, and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness. in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Bringing you out of darkness, so come take my light to the world. I am the bread you must feed to the hungry, the wine that must cheer every heart. Foxes have holes, birds have their nest, but the Son of Man has no place to rest. Come, follow me, be the light of the nations. Leave your nets and come follow me. Leave your nets and come follow me.
Christ had to suffer and on the third day rise from the dead. In his name, repentance and remission of sins must be preached to all the nations. Alleluia. Luke chapter 24, verses 46 to 47. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Say the prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for an efficacious control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We thank you for blessing the efforts of our research scientists working on the development of a vaccine. We pray that these vaccines will be effective in combating the virus and its mutants and in controlling the spread of the pandemic. We pray that the vaccine be available for all our people, even the poor and those in rural areas. We pray for doctors, nurses and health workers who are in the front line of this battle, that they be kept safe and have the strength and courage to continue their heroic efforts. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Kindly bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. After each invocation, our responses, Amen. May God, who by the resurrection of His only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by His blessing.
Amen.
May He, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with Him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I tell you now, go proclaim, I give to you my spirit's flame. He is at work inside of you to overcome all the powers of darkness. Go into the world, tell them I'm alive. Go into the streets, tell them that I live. Go into the streets, dry your people's tears. Oh, making all